What's up, guys? It's Chase from Chase's Workshop, and in this video, we're going to go through the tube screamer schematics that I found on electrosmash.com. If you hadn't been there, I'll leave a link in the description. Go check it out. It's a pretty cool website. They've got a bunch of different pedals that you can get the schematics for. You can get the parts list and all that stuff for it. So I got this schematic from Electrosmash. Now, I built it on this breadboard here. Now, what I want to do is I want to take this breadboard, I want to hook it up to my oscilloscope, and then I want to put a signal into it from a signal generator so we can kind of chase it through there and see what the different parts of the circuit do to the signal. So I thought that'd be pretty neat. And then when we get done, we're going to plug it up and see what it sounds like. So guys, if you have any questions or comments, and especially any suggestions of anything that I can do to make this thing sound different than it already does, please leave them in the comments or shoot me an email or whatever. I'm doing this not only to help myself more than anything, but also to maybe get some ideas from you guys and help y'all too. So if you have any questions, like I said, leave them below. If you like the video, give me a like, and if you like it, please subscribe. Thanks for watching, guys. Well, alright guys, so here is the circuit. I've got it built. I was going to go through here and show you how I put everything together and try to make it as in-depth as I could, but it was just I couldn't do all this and try to get everything where you could see how point to point how everything went. But now I did go exactly by this schematic here. I had to change a few values because I didn't have a 510k resistor here, so I used a 560, but I am going to get those and put them in correctly. I didn't put this diode in here because all this is a it's just where if you hook the power up in reverse, it doesn't fry everything. So this isn't in here. Everything else is pretty much exactly like the schematic says. Now what I want to do here is I want to go through, and if you can see on the screen right now, on the oscilloscope, you can see a sine wave there. Right now I've got that at 210 hertz. And I found that to be the best spot to where I can kind of show you what this circuit does and how these things work. Now, the first thing we're going to go through right here is I'm just going to run through the schematics right quick and show you what's doing what. Now, of course, we've got our input here from our guitar. We've got our signal coming in, going through a coupling capacitor, going into a buffing circuit. And basically all this does pretty much is it just kind of keeps integrity of the signal to where it keeps it the same, because when the signal runs through long cables and runs through a bunch of effects pedals and stuff like that, a lot of times the signal integrity can get broken down. You run it through a buffer circuit, it helps keep it consistent. So it comes out of that. There's not really much amplification at all right here. Yeah, I don't think there is any at all, but I will go through here in just a minute. I'm going to pin through these spots and show them to you on the oscilloscope. So once it comes through there, it goes to another coupling capacitor. And if you don't know what a coupling capacitor is, basically it blocks DC voltage. It allows AC voltage to flow through, which our signal is AC, and it blocks DC voltage. So if you look right here, we've got 4.5 volts coming into our signal right here. This is blocking it from going back onto our guitar input, our pickups and all that stuff. So it's blocking it there, and it's allowing it to go through here. This one's doing the exact same thing. It's blocking the voltage that it gained here, blocking it from this, what we're fixing to add right here. So anyways, it goes to that coupling capacitor through a resistor here, and then this adds another 4.5 volts here, goes into our op amp, comes out of our op amp, goes through our clipping circuit right here, which is this guy right there. I'm going to try to get this where I can focus in on it. Our clipping circuit right there, with our distortion knob and all that stuff, comes out of that, goes back into the next spot of the op amp, which is the same op amp, but they're just drawn out different. Goes to the second stage, does the exact same thing, comes out on pin 7, except it goes through a tone pot right here. And then comes out, goes through a volume pot, and then comes out, goes to another coupling capacitor. Coupling capacitor here, volume pot, coupling capacitor, adds in another 4.5 volts and 9 volts here to our transistor. And this is the second stage of the buffing circuit. So this is just another buffer circuit right here. And then it goes out through a coupling capacitor and out to your amp. So that's basically it for the schematics. And all this is down here is just a power supply. You've just got some filter capacitors here, and then this is just a voltage divider. So we got 9 volts. If you use the same resistor sizes, the middle pin here will be half the voltage. So we're just stepping that 9 volts down to 4.5 volts right there. And that's it. Now what I want to do is, let's get to the cool part of it, I guess. Now what you're seeing on the screen right now is my input coming in. And it's coming in right here. Now I've got it coming in over here on the side just through this here, and it's coming through a signal generator that I'm using with one of my old cell phones that I had. But it's coming in, it's going through this little switch right here, and this is just a bypass. So if I flip this thing off, you'll see it goes to nothing. Flip back on, it goes to what signal we got coming in here. So there's where it comes in at. Right now you're just getting the raw signal from the signal generator there. Now the first spot I want to look at is I want to show you how the coupling capacitor works right quick. And right now if you look, we should have 4.5 volts on this side and we should have nearly nothing on this side if the coupling capacitor works like it says it does. So let me get my voltmeter out here and try to get it up here where you can see it, I hope. And what I want to do is I'll give you a voltage reading. Pull this out. Okay, we're going to go on the back side of the capacitor, so we should have voltage here. 2.133 volts right there. Now, if I come on the back side of it, I have 0.3 millivolts. I have a very small amount. So there is some going through, but not much at all. So 2.130, and then we've got 0 here. That's what the coupling capacitor does. It allows the AC voltage to flow through, and it blocks the DC voltage. So let me hook this back up to our signal. So there's our signal coming in. I'm going to go right on the other side of that capacitor, and as you can tell, it doesn't do anything. It's basically the exact same signal. But anyway, so now what I want to do is I want to go through, and I'm going to look at, once it comes out of this buffer circuit right here, and through this capacitor here, and that we're going to be reading pin 3 on the op amp. And that's going to be right there. So there's pin 3. That's basically has went through the buffer circuit and has traveled to the op amp that we have. Now, if you can look at the amplitude here where we're at on the screen, we're right at the first line here. I'm going to go back and look at where it comes in at. And you can tell there's not been hardly any amplification. So the buffer circuit's just kind of keeping the signal, a strong signal. So that's simple enough. Now the next part I want to look at is, once it goes into 3, I want to see where it comes out of 1 right here. And 1 is going to start our clipping circuit. So we're going to look, I want to come to pin 3 right here, which is hooked to pin 1, the middle pin on our distortion pot, and see what kind of signal we're getting right here off of this clipping circuit. So here's my distortion knob. I'm going to clip right on the middle pin, and as you can tell, we have some amplification. Now what I want to do is I'm going to turn this back down and try to get a better signal here. So there's that. Okay, now what this pot does, or what this clipping circuit does, is once I start adding increase into it, it starts clipping, and that's what these little look kind of square. Now if I go smaller, you'll be able to see it better. But it adds clipping to our signal. And that's where our distortion comes in. That's where our tone and all that stuff comes in, as you can tell there. And the way this circuit does it is by these diodes right here. There's two diodes that are flip-flop from each other. I've seen two where people have used LEDs, they've used diodes, all kinds of stuff to see what kind of sound you can get. And that's something I want to experiment with, is changing these out to different value diodes or LEDs, big LEDs, small LEDs, and just see what it does to the circuit there. But that's all that does. That's the basic clipping part of the circuit here. And that's what it does. If you look on the screen, you can see that it makes this, turns the normal sine wave and almost into a kind of like a square wave. And it amplifies it. Because if we go back now and look at our input signal, you'll see how much smaller it is than what we have now. Let me slow this thing down here. So there's our input signal. And there's our clipped signal. So it has amplified it. Now what I want to do is I want to go through back to what comes out of pin 1. We went through this clipping circuit where it comes in on pin 5 here. It comes out on pin 7. So I want to go to pin 7 and look at it and see what it looks like. So pin 7. 7. It's going to be right on the back side of this capacitor right here. And here is our tone knob. Let's see what it does to it. Okay, it just shapes the top a little bit, kind of cleans it up. So there you go. That's what that does. This kind of cleans up the tops of the peaks and stuff. All right, so there's that. So we just took a measurement right in here, right there, between the C7 and the 1K, or C7 and R12 right here. Then it goes through our volume pot. So we're going to go right here. We're just going to go ahead and go on out to our output right here and see what our signal looks like out here now. So that's going to be right there. And there's our output signal. Now this whole experiment's been done with the volume cut all the way up. So now that I've passed my volume pot, I can come in here and adjust this thing to, you know, a lower level, higher level, and that way you can see. So that's basically what our circuit, that's what our signal looks like once it goes through the tube screamer. Let me adjust the distortion knob here. So there you go. Pretty simple circuit. Pretty much pretty cool too to actually see. That's why I wanted this oscilloscope, was to not only for me to learn how these different signals are changed and stuff like that, and to where I can show you guys too of how this stuff works. Now, with all the crap done, let's plug this thing up and see what it sounds like. Well, all right, guys, here I am. I've got the my Stratocaster out here. I've got the pedal sitting on my table here, and I've got it plugged up and everything running through it. Now I'm playing through the line 6. DT25 right there. I've got everything pretty much set on 50% just to kind of get a baseline of what it'll sound like. Now this is the amp without the pedal, so this is got a little reverb. I'm in drop D too. Alright, now I'm gonna plug the or hook the pedal up, or flip the switch to the pedal, I guess. Now there is a lot of noise in the pedal, just because I don't have it in a actual enclosure. Nothing's really shielded, so I've got lights everywhere in this place. My oscilloscope's still running, and so everything's it's got a lot of feedback, as you can tell there. This is what it sounds like with the pedal. I've got the tone about halfway, and I've got the distortion all the way up and the volume all the way up.
Thank you.
Now the tone knob on this guy, if I go all the way open with it, it's pretty harsh, but that's expected, I guess, with the tone knob being all the way up. I've been running about, I don't know, 3/4 to 1/2. There's that. Now I'm gonna cut the distortion down about halfway. So it breaks up nicely, I think, right there, especially for like some stuff like that, you know, where you can kind of mess around with it. Now what I want to do next in this guy, before I start trying to figure out how to put this thing into a pedal, is I want to experiment with the diodes, where I can, you know, you can change those guys out and get different sounds and stuff like that. There's even people that's used LEDs for that. So I think that might be kind of interesting to do. And then, like I said in the beginning of this video, if any of you guys know of a way to change this guy up, let me know too. Now, like I said in the previous part of the video too, some of these components are not 100% like the schematics. One being the resistor going where the 4.5 volts goes into it. So I'm going to try to order some of those, get them here, and see if that changes the sound. I don't know if it will or not. I don't think that it will a whole lot, but like I said, I don't know to tell. I think to run it by the specs might get it exactly like a tube screamer. But anyway, that's what it sounds like, and hope you think it sounds good. I think it does. I think it sounds... I didn't know that I would even be able to make the pedal, so I think it sounds really good. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed this. If you have any questions or comments about any of this stuff, just leave them below or send me an email or whatever. Guys, I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give me a like. Thanks for watching, guys.